Evelyn Cook has been a dedicated volunteer with the Ukrainian Catholic Women's League of Canada, St. Basil's Branch, and Edmonton Eparchy Executive. She has also worked on the St. Basil's Museum Committee as well. Evelyn was instrumental in providing leadership, volunteering her time and talents. She has been a member of the UCWLC St. Basil's Branch for almost 40 years, serving as president, secretary, and on various committees, proudly promoting Ukrainian religion and culture. Most recently, Evelyn's involvement in the UCWLC Eparchial Executive is her work on the Museum Committee, taking on many projects culminating as chair of the committee. Her various achievements include organizing workshops for school children, Heritage Day projects, joint projects with various local museums. Presently, she is proud to serve as chair of the UCWLC's Eparchial Museum. Evelyn Cook continues to volunteer her time, talents, effort, and expertise in order to keep the Ukrainian-Canadian community in Alberta strong, vibrant, and active.
Well, I did start with the UCWLC at the branch level in 1991, and then joined the Eparchial, which is the nominating group. It was a big learning curve for me. It was delightful. The friendships are fabulous, but for the UCWLC, it was intellectually for me, I didn't know a lot of Ukrainian-Canadian history, or even some of the traditions and third generation. So it was enriching that way. And for the UCWLC, with their aims and goals, what interested me the most, the social justice initiatives. And I worked for the Ukrainian Catholic Eparchy as the ecumenical officer. Some of the groups that I've been involved with, there's one called No Room in the Inn. And the churches donate, and it's around the idea that Jesus, no room in the inn. And we pick a housing project. We ask the Christian churches to donate. Sometimes maybe 55, 60, 65, 75,000 might come in. So that one, when I've gone to the UCWLC, the branches, they're the ones that make the donations. It's very satisfying, and the friendships, working on the projects, feeling that you do contribute. And it is hard to say no, because you believe in what has to be done, whether it's in the parishes or in the community. I could give you the names of 10 people that have done as much as myself or more. But it's kind of nice. It was very nice. It was surprising. The president called and said, would you accept the Hetman Award? And there's always an awareness of past winners, and I don't know that I thought that I would be in that category. So it's quite delightful, though.
My involvement with Barvina began many, many years ago when my children began dancing. And as we all know, volunteering in an organization where your children are involved is very, very important, not only to the growth of the organization, but to support your own children as they're developing and learning and being a part of that particular community. Over the years, my involvement grew and took on many roles within the executive, one of which being the costume director, and that was the one that I spent most of my years with. It was also the most enjoyable, most gratifying part was working with the children and working with the parents. As an educator, I brought a lot of my own skills and my own viewpoints on how to encourage youth to become involved and to love what they're doing and to develop a passion for what they're doing. And I think through volunteering and demonstrating that passion that I had, I think I was able to pass that on to the younger generation as well. So volunteering, I kind of baby stepped into it, mostly beginning with my own children, but it just grew and grew, and it made me understand my own culture and love my culture more and more as we went along. When I received notice that I was receiving this award, I was absolutely left speechless because, first of all, it's wonderful to be recognized locally, and I'd like to thank Barvina for doing that, for taking the initiative and putting my name forward. And that in itself has left me speechless. But to be recognized is just so humbling, absolutely humbling. And I'd like to thank everyone for that, for acknowledging my work.
I volunteer in the Ukrainian community in Calgary because it's so small. And there are a lot of Ukrainians that live in Calgary that say that they're of Ukrainian heritage. There's not a lot that are really, truly involved in the Ukrainian community. So by volunteering with various organizations, with church and with Kurinya, it helps me help the Ukrainian community by promoting it, by exposing other people to it, by keeping our traditions and cultures alive, and especially when it's something as fun as Kurinya, which is multicultural in the sense that, yes, we're Ukrainian, we sing, we're Ukrainian folk choir, but we perform in various venues that expose the Ukrainian culture to people beyond the Ukrainian community, which is kind of fun, especially in this town. Singing, dancing, whatever we can do to the rest of the community is really important. It helps us keep our Ukrainian culture alive. And it instills, I think, in other people who may not be so involved, may not be participating, might not be observing traditions and customs, that it might kind of encourage them to do something along those lines, even if it's just personal for their own self or their family or whatever. Yeah, it is mostly a lot of joy. It's a lot of fun working with all of the people that I've met in the Calgary Ukrainian community. I'm just really grateful to have met all these people and to consider them friends. And, it is really very joyful.
When my girls first started to decide what they want to do with their life, they came up to me and they said, "Mom, what do you think we should do?" And I said to them, "Well, I'm not going to tell you what to do and what not to do, but I'm going to tell you one thing, that whatever you take on, don't take it on because you want to be popular, because you want to be prosperous, or you want to have prestige, or to please yourself." So then my daughter says to me, "Well, what's left?" And I said, "Well, regardless of what you take on, take something on where you'll be of service to others, because if you'll be of service of others, you'll be serving God, and in time, if you do a good job doing what you're doing, you may be being rich, you may be being popular, and you'll be pleasing others." So myself, I always try to go and give help where help is needed. Right now, I'm mostly involved in helping seniors that want to stay home, but yet they need the essentials. The volunteers that I've taken on, I first start with the Ukrainian Catholic Women's League, and I enjoyed the working with the ladies and doing something for the church. I think that's where I really sort of got my ground. And then later, somebody approached us about Meals on Wheels. So I started with Meals on Wheels, and I've been with them for 47 years. But again, it's to be of service to others.
Причина є в тому, що, знаєте, я колись, ви пам'ятаєте, був бичо, послугував. І як він ще вже пішов на відпочинок, то вже не було нікого, либо хто послугував. А ви знаєте, як я вже вийшов на пенсію, то я вже мав вільний час. І тоді, знаєте, я хотів тримати те, як було перед тим, щоб священник самий не відповідав Службі Божої, так щоб хтось все був відповідати Службі Божої. І того я так, як вже на пенсію вийшов, який може вже повер 20 літ тому, і я перебрав і так далі, то притримую. Бо бачите, як ви бачите, дуже мало хлопців послугує. То так, що я маю, я близько церкви мешкаю, і так, знаєте, що коли потрібно, чи ключа, як ви знаєте, чи щось таке, то все до мене телефонує, щоб там прийти, бо мені близько так. І так, і як то колись, знаєте, як ще був Стефан Лопичук при парафії, то ми все-таки все разом робили там, ще було щось направити, чи щось, чи там прорахтувати вже фурнеце на зиму, то так ми все оба старалися то робити. Тепер трошки вже зміна зробилася, бо, знаєте, вже люди вже постарили, відходили до старечого дому, чи вже декотрі помирали. А я кажу, поки що я годен, я хочу далі ще протримувати це. Кажу, часом є хлопці, послугують, але часом немає, як ви бачите, то я вже буду заступати їх. Я є вдячний і дякую їм, я не знаю, хто номінував мене, але я кажу, така була сподіванка для мене, що я ще довідав про це. То для мене була велика сподіванка, бо я сподівався, що то є люди, які вже працюють вже руками. Бо я кажу, я в парафії від 58-го року членом є, то так аж дотеперка. І я не знаю, чи я заслужився на це чи ні, але я подякую всім вам.
My whole philosophy or motivation, I guess, to volunteering, especially with Ukraine and in the Ukrainian community, is the very first time I visited my relatives in Ukraine, I thought to myself, there but for the grace of God go I. And almost immediately I felt this very, very strong compulsion, and it really is a compulsion, that I have to give back in some way, shape, or form. I want to use my talents and abilities to give back, and I'm a really good English language teacher, I think, and so that's why I teach English in Ukraine. I think that with English speaking abilities, the youth, especially in Ukraine, will have far greater possibilities in Ukraine and in the world. And I also extend my interest in giving back to the world, to the immigrant community as well, because it's really all tied to the fact that my forebears were brave enough to come here and to give me the life that I have myself. And I am eternally grateful for that. I had never heard of the Hetman Awards before, so when Halia notified me that I was being nominated for this award, I was just absolutely flabbergasted and even more flabbergasted and honored that I actually am a recipient of this award. So I just feel very honored to be given this reward, and I'm gratified that people do notice, and it means a great deal to me to have the Ukrainian community recognize the things that I do.